Hello everyone and welcome back. This is game one of the winner's round matchup between Madness969 and Ta. Madness chose the first map. He chose one of my favorites, Forest Goalie, at night, interestingly enough. And he is over here in the red as the Mori over on the Hojo. The automatic favorite because he's playing Hojo is Ta, but a very strong showing in round number one, and also has a very strong fan base, it seems. Has some little cheering sections in his own game, so we'll see if Madness can pull up the seeming upset against Ta, who's apparently one of the favorites to maybe win this tournament. So this is on Madness's map, so we should have the advantage here. Like I said, it's Forest Goalie. I love this map, absolutely love it. The crabbing potential is huge. It's just such a well-designed map, the way the buildings are. To capture them, you basically have to concede this ridge, which really opens it up to missile play. You could crab with some bow cavalry over here, even, and just hammer away any units trying to capture these buildings. Wide and open for the cavalry, but they're hills, too, so you can't just go running up a hill and getting a downhill charge in your face. Let's take a look at the army setups. I guess I should talk about that. We have some bow samurai over here from Ta. It's an excellent skirmish map, so of course you want to bring some bows on this one, for the reasons I just mentioned about the ridge, among others. And, oh, look at this. This is like an old-school Naginata Corps. We haven't seen one of those. I mean, I haven't seen that since, what, May, April? Like, really old-school Naginata Corps. Naginatas, like 10 of them for the infantry, and then, you know, some nice bow and cavalry support. I love it. I can't wait to see this battle. I'm almost kind of cheering for Ta because I love that old-school sort of Naginata Corps. It's just sad you never see it. Anyway, looking over at Madness. Looks like he's got the elite Yari Ashigaru spear wall idea going on. These rank 5 Yari Ashigaru up in front. One in the back there. Naginata Monk. What's he got for swords? Looks like he has 2 katanas over here. A Kisho Ninja who is hidden. And 2 Nodachis in the forest. Crabbing with Nodachis. Very interesting. He is going to be on the attack in this game as he chose the map. His bow cavalry is moving out to make some preliminary attacks. Maybe just trying to cut him off from the building as well. Both the buildings on the edges have been captured. That means Ta will have the archery dojo and Madness has the shrine. So works a little bit in Madness's favor if he attacks soon, but if he lets the skirmish go on too long, that archery dojo will be huge. We're looking over at Madness's side. He has no foot archers. He just has the 2 mobile and somewhat weaker bow cavalry, so he's going to have to really skirmish well to win this skirmish fight, not having the archery dojo. Of course, having the... Oh, no, they don't have the workshop. I'm sorry. I just got a little confused. That won't help him at all in the skirmish battle. He does not have the workshop, so... Looking over here, Madness, and Madness has a nice little position set up here. What's this? A Yari Ashigaru. And he could get a nice downhill charge for his Nodachi. This could be absolutely huge. If you can hold him down with the Yari spear wall and just get a big Nodachi charge into the rear downhill at a fairly steep angle, that could be absolutely huge. This is going to be very interesting on both sides. I love what both sides have going on in this battle. We have an old school Naginata Corps versus Yari Ashigaru's spear wall with some interesting Nodachi crabbing. I'm really looking forward to this one. And it's a knight, too, which just makes it that much more dramatic. Great guard coming out now for Madness as well. Coming up in the front. Gonna have to be careful here, though. Losing some men early. Lost 4 in that unit. Might just be a distraction. Buying time for his units to get into position. And here comes the Yari cavalry out of the rear and the Yari Ashigaru. Where is this Yari cavalry going to go? He's got to have somewhere. Oh, there's a Great Guard right there to stop him, though. This cavalry will not be able to do anything. This Great Guard can stop it. But he's going downhill, so if he can push through... Oh, stopped like a brick wall. That Great Guard is right in the way. And interestingly, Top hops his rally. A little early for that, I think. But I guess we'll see. There go the Yari Ashigaru. No problem there. And that attack totally failed. Just hit that Great Guard spear wall and could not get through. One thing that really helped with your cavalry usage is if you put them into guard mode, for some reason they don't get stuck on enemy units. I don't know why that is, but it is. So if you're looking for highly mobile cavalry, be sure to put them in guard mode. Maybe that would have saved the Yari cavalry there. Who knows? Yari Ashigaru in front, in loose formation. Kind of interesting. I don't know what he's planning on doing. Maybe just to be a net to catch cavalry, or maybe just be kind of a roadblock and stop the enemy from making a good organized charge against his line. But then, oh, the Nodachis, I almost missed it. They're coming in for the charge. Oh, but going into right into Yari Ashigaru is going to be a big waste. Charge gets stopped early because it looks like they got hung up on this Great Guard. Banzai coming out now and into the rear of the knight. That's going to be a pretty good charge. Killing 20 and still counting. 23 men, it looks like the final count in the charge, but just can get swarmed. He's got to push now. He's got to make this coax, or counter, got to make him pair up with an infantry attack here. Oh, and that those matchlocks are tearing him apart, but just end up routing the own Yari Ashigaru. So if these Yari Ashigaru from Madness can cut through and maybe hold down these matchlock samurai, and actually Madness's cavalry is in a pretty good position, but this Great Guard might need some more heroics again, going up against two Great Guard from Madness. And his infantry attack, the Yari Ashigaru spear wall is not so good on the attack, because number one, it's slow if you're going to be in the spear wall, and when they are in spear wall, they lose their fatigue. And so that really hurts their morale as well. When Ashigaru get fatigued, that is not good. And this attack looks like it's crumbling. Toss spread out nice and long, which was actually a very good way to go, as there weren't a whole lot of infantry for Madness, so he just wasn't able to get around and make any real damage. So attacks can get stopped here by Toss fairly easily, spread out nice and wide. Good old-school Naginata action, grinding down that melee fight and really making a lot of use of his missile units. Even his matchlocks in the rear of the infantry are managing to get some nice gaps to shoot through. And of course they're up on top of the hill too, which gives them a good angle. And they're just going to be able to rain down fire into the infantry of Madness. And it looks like Ta is going to take convincing game one victory. Though I do believe there was corruption in this game. I think this was before the patch, so there is some corruption most likely. Maybe the players would like to illuminate us a little bit on what maybe happened or didn't happen, but Ta is the winner of this fight. In fact, if you see a battle has been corrupted and you see a player trying to clarify what happened, then if you please like their comments so it gets shown on the top comments so everybody can see what they're trying to say. Bow cavalry over here are going to be sort of last-ditch effort, and actually the remnants of Madness's force are holding out pretty well, but there's just going to be way too much here. The Great Guard just got totally just stopped here by that hero Great Guard of Ta. Really coming through there. If those attacks had gotten past that Great Guard in those two instances, the Yari Cavalry and the Nodachis, and the Great Guard, I guess there were actually three, and that would have been potentially a battle changer. So Great Guard being here, so this is definitely a map for heroics. This is where I had my heroic light cavalry battle too, so I just, so many memories on this map. I totally love it. And that's going to be it though. Ta is taking game one and going up in the series, moving on to his home turf, so Ta has a big advantage going into this. We'll see what happens in the next battle. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you on the main menu. Well, what can I say? Madness really tried a ballsy attack there, and I gotta give him props for trying it. It was pretty risky, but had potential to be very entertaining. I don't think the Yari Ashigaru spear wall really works very well with an ambush timing setup like he had going there. Just wasn't able to move into position fast enough, and the timings got all messed up, and so the attack ended up crumbling, but it was a really good concept, I thought. At least the ambush part of it I really liked, and I want to see more of that sort of thing. I mean, crabbing with Nodachis, I don't think I've ever really seen that before, so definitely saw something new there, and it's a potentially a great idea. I think if he would have gotten a good charge off, he would have won. Probably why he chose the map at night, trying to get as much of a surprise as he could, and maybe just hoping that Ta wouldn't see it in the darkness, but see it he did, and had very good defensive micro to just shut down all the attacks going into his force. So well played there by Ta, and he's getting the map choice going into the next map, so I will see you there. Thanks for watching, everybody.